So I'm about 3 miles into a ride. It's a little chilly this morning. It's really perfect, but it's been warm, so I'm not used to the cold again. Feels good. And rode hard for about 2 miles. So I kind of slowed it down. I'll pick it back up again in a little bit. His earliest disciples often found themselves in holding patterns, waiting on Christ to finish some unforeseen task, or placed on standby while he attempted to call someone out of a tree, or try to persuade someone to stand on legs that had never actually worked. Detours were inevitable because you never knew when Jesus might need to go a certain way, to drink from a specific well, or to try and pull fruit from a barren tree. He might even send you ahead alone while he set himself apart just for some personal me time. Sure that this pattern of pauses and routine breaks raised a few eyebrows. His disciples would often ask, "Why are we here?" Or "What did that parable actually mean?" It really does all add up to this. Some of the blanks in life are not spaces that require answers. Often they're merely pauses, a break from the rhetoric, or a cessation from our labors. Whether a breather or a time of reflection, we need a place in life to put a comma. Sometimes just a spot to slow down. We need to learn to prepare for the Sundays in our week, or the Saturdays, wherever you prescribe your day of rest or worship. But rest is a necessity, and it sometimes needs to be forced on us. These sudden spaces, these stop signs and red lights, they may be signals for us to use our brakes. Maybe an intersection along our course, or simply a good place to look left or right. And most of us can remember our parents telling us to always look both ways before crossing a street or an intersection. It may not have seemed important at the time, but this was pure wisdom. We tend to make rolling stops, and eventually we become dangerously comfortable just barreling through intersections, bobbling our heads one way and then another, and just plowing through. But the temptation to plow through the stop signs in life, they can be fatal. So we need to learn to slow down. Living in a hurry only brings our hurdles closer together. It reduces our spacing in life. And so rushing to fill a space can be like trying to answer a question that was never really asked. You don't want to walk ahead of God's will. Pauses are not always hesitations. Sometimes they are simply the reminder to just stop and breathe. Maybe it's a nudge to step back, survey your surroundings, to ponder your position. Most importantly, make sure to keep your mind on Christ. Keep your eyes on the cross. What is it they say? The life you save might just be your own, or something like that. Anyhow, you have a wonderful day. Keep moving forward and be blessed.